Okay.
So here's the first video with our dyno set up. Got the water coolant running over here. See, it's running through, it's sucking here, going through the pump into that controller, to that motor, to that motor, to that controller, and then just dumps it right back in here. It's flowing at, I don't know what the rate is, but it's a pretty good flow rate through that. So I think it's probably keeping it cool. And the two Nissan Leaf, 2013 Nissan Leaf controllers are just connected in parallel. And they're both connected, right now it's just to about 93 volts from a Chevy Volt battery pack. Later, we'll up it all the way to, I don't know, 380 volts or whatever it is. But right now it's just 93. And a friend of mine up in Canada had this made, where it mates the motor shafts are mated together in the middle there, and it's bolted nice and tight together with this thing. It's not aligned perfectly, but right now it's okay, I guess. I'll play around with it to get it lined up better later. Right now, also, I have them both running in torque mode in opposite directions. And so whoever has the higher torque is going to cause the motor to, it's going to cause them to spin one way or the other. And also, a little later, maybe in a few days, I'm going to have one run in speed, constant speed mode, and then the other one can do different torque commands. And we'll do some experiments with that. But for now, I guess we could run it just with both of them in torque mode. So, let's see. So here's my little control area. Over here. So this turns on, this pre-charges the both capacitor banks. And it takes a few seconds. And then this closes the main contactor. And then this turns on the far away motor. And this one turns on, the far away controller. And this one turns on the closer controller. And these are two throttles for the two controllers right now. Okay. So, one interesting thing is when the IGBTs are off on the second controller, it just acts like a load that just sends all the power straight back to the batteries, and it, so the other motor is barely able to turn it, maybe at like a 1 revolution per second or so, and that's like forcing all the power right back, so you can, and that way you can kind of test it at full torque near 0 RPM, which is kind of a neat little thing. So here's what that sounds like. Let's see here. Whoa. Thank you. So it's twisting it right now. Let's see here. So right now it's turning at about 50 revolutions per minute inside there. And the other one is completely off, and so it's just shunting all the power right back. And so right now it's using about 2.6 amps. Coming off of the batteries in just wasted heat by that one grinding away, forcing the other one to turn as it just shorts it straight back to the batteries again. So now I'll turn that off, and you can kind of hear it growl a little bit as it came to a stop. Now I'm going to stream the amps, and it just keeps it at about 50 RPM. So I'll start from the right. Both of them have a battle where I turn the other one on. You can hear the not perfectly, whatever. But part of that's just the bearing in there jiggling around, I think. Now here's the other one, gonna fight it and slow it down. Balancing act between the two, so I'm going to capture this data. Let's see. Start the overwrite. Careful. So, that left one's fine. Now, okay, the left one is running, now the right one is slowing it down, and now it's put one out and spinning it the other way. Okay. Now I'm gradually reducing the torque on both of them until they both come to a stop. Okay. Oh man, I overwrote the other one. Oh, that's a bummer. Okay, now we'll turn. off. Okay. Now, I guess I'll run the test one more time where the other controller is just totally shut off and just shunts the power back to the batteries, and so it won't go very fast. Let's see. So, well, let's turn both off first. Okay. So, recharge. Recharge. This isn't a good place for me to walk. Yeah, extreme.